was treasuring all these things in her heart and meditating on them. Treasuring these things in her heart. And that's a beautiful thing that she treasured them. But if you think about a treasure chest, what does a treasure chest usually consist of? It's usually very sturdy. It's usually closed. But it's usually got a lock on the front of it.
That's right, Doc.
See, sometimes we lock up the blessings that God has given us in our hearts. Encourage us each and every day, but what about taking that lock off and opening up and allowing the gold, if you will, inside the treasure box, the light to hit the gold and then the shine off so somebody else can see it.
That's right.
So we lock up too many things on the inside of us. Yes, it encourages us. Yes, it strengthens us. So why not share it with somebody else? Because if God really means that much to you, you will want to share.
Maybe this one.
You see, the thing about God is because you share doesn't mean
his tears on her.
Verse 20. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they seen and heard. They left glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard. It's just simply duplication. You see, when the angel came down, it says heavenly hosts came down with them. And what were they doing? Singing glory and hallelujah. They were singing highest praise unto God. They were just simply doing what they already seen. See, Jesus came down on earth and showed us how to live, so we can simply duplicate it. When was the last time you duplicated giving glory to God? When was the last time you duplicated giving praises to God? When was the last time you duplicated what you had seen Christ do for you? See, if Christ gave you a blessing, when was the last time you duplicated giving somebody else a blessing?
Amen.
See, we love taking Facebook pictures of our Christmas tree and all the presents laying underneath the tree. But what about taking a picture of you taking one of your presents from underneath your tree and handing it to somebody else? So then maybe somebody else gets that in their heart and they duplicate the same thing and then they give. And then they give. And before you know it, the ones of us who have and the ones of us who don't have, we're all on common ground because everybody has it.
Yeah, come on.
We're willing to share.
Amen.
When was the last time you duplicated what you seen?
Come on, God.
It said they were seeing the highest praise unto God. So what did the shepherds do after seeing him? They left out praising God. They left out giving him glory. They left out, oh my God, I just seen the Messiah. Oh my God, I just seen the Savior. Oh my God, he's here. He's alive. He's in
come
a manger. He's wrapped in swaddling clothes.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but we about to get delivered from this Roman rule. We about to get delivered from these physical ailments. We about to get delivered from these struggles. And it also said he was willing to do more than that. We about to get delivered from our sins. Giving God glory and praises because they actually went and seen him.
Yeah.
See, when you come to church, you came to see who? Who did you come to see? Did you come to hear a song? Did you come to hear a word? Who did you come to see?
Come on.
Every time we enter into his house, it should be to come to see him.
Amen.
And after we come to see him, when we leave out, what are we supposed to take with us?
Him.
Amen. And then when we roll up on somebody else, we all say, oh man, what's going on? How you doing? And dap everybody up and all that. But what are we supposed to do? Share what we came with this guy.
Amen.
Man, I want some more stuff.
This is when they left. They left giving all glory, glorifying in all praises unto God, because they just had an encounter with him.
Yeah.
And see, when you simply duplicate praise and worship and give glory to God, it should be contagious.
Yep, amen.
And what does that do?
Come on.
That shows somebody else, oh, you got all of that when you went to church? You came out feeling like that? You came out looking like that? You know what, next Sunday, what church you go to again? Oh, yeah,
that's
the little church in the back of the building on South Main Street.
Amen, amen.
Virginia, you know what? They're more than welcome to come here. But they go about what they see you do.
Amen.
Oh. So when you go back to work on tomorrow, or kids, when y'all get ready to go back to school in a couple days in now,
I'm bored.
What they gonna see when you walk in? We going to work.
Oh, it's Monday morning. I'm getting my cup of coffee. Oh, I did not want to get up. Oh, the weekend wasn't long enough. And oh, Lord, I done spent all this money on Christmas gift. I done swiped all 18 of my credit cards. I took out a loan. Now I got to pay back the loan. Now I need to get a raise on my job to make no money to pay off the debt. I
mean, come on, come on.
Now I'm stressed out. And now it's a new year. And now
come on, come on, Nelson.
Taxes is due. And all the time I paid him. I paid all this money for all these gifts.
Wait a minute, this sweater is too big. These pants is too small.
Did he just say he broke?
You don't want these old things to weigh you down, so what would you?